Nick, talk about what you have been seeing and hearing.
Well, certainly to the south of where I'm standing in Kryvyi Rih, there are a number of villages, particularly now in the crosshairs of a renewed Russian offensive pushing north to where I am. Some of them, though, were held in fact earlier by Russia prior to their liberation by the Ukrainian military. And one story we heard involves the behavior of one particular Russian unit in a village not far from where I'm standing. And as you pointed out, we should remind people this is a graphic story of quite horrifying content involving the sexual assault of a 16-year-old pregnant girl by Russian troops who were only briefly in the village where she was living. Again, I should warn you, this report does contain some disturbing content.
It's from these gentle shrugs of villages, lazy and clean, in the green expanses of Kherson region, that some of this war's ugliest crimes are being dragged into the light. This is Dasha. She's 16 and was 6 months pregnant when, just over a month ago, Russian forces came to her village here. Her family were in the basement sheltering from bombs, the cold, and the Russians shooting in the air or at cars and legs, she said. At dusk, they brought the children out to the kitchen to eat, where there were two soldiers, one drunk.
І він спитав, скільки кому год. Там по дівчинка, їй було 12, одній по 14 і мені 16. Сначала він погукав маму в окрему кімнату. Маму він швидко відпустив, а потім мене погукав. А потім він почав кричати, ну, спочатку він сказав, щоб я роздівалася. Ну, я сказала, що я не буду роздіватися, і почав на мене кричати. І сказав, якщо я не буду роздіватися, він мене, ну, пристрелить.
His sober colleague then came in and told the drunk attacker to stop, to no avail, and left.
Коли я сопротивлялася, він мене придушував і казав, що пристрелить. Або він каже, або ти за мною, ну, спиш зараз, або я зараз приведу 20 чоловік.
By then, night had fallen in the cold house.
Я тільки що пам'ятаю, що у нього були голубі глаза. А так там було темно, просто я не заповнювалася.
She heard the Russian say her attacker's name was Blue. He was from Donetsk and had a criminal past. He tried to attack her again, she said, until Russian snipers later came to help her.
But still some of the Russian soldiers in that unit even were disgusted by what happened and tried to move her and part of her family away to safety. And then began a process in which Russian soldiers seemed to try to get her to go back on the claim she'd made.
2 days later, she was taken to a Russian paratrooper commander who, she said, began shouting at her like her attacker had.
Ну, і казав, що, ну, буде робити зі мною те, що і він робив. А коли я вже здихалася сильно і почала плакати, то він сказав, що, ну, що це була перевірка, щоб він убедився, чи я, ну, брешу, чи це було насправді.
It seems they did believe her, but the fate of her rapist remains unclear. While we can't independently verify her harrowing story, Ukrainian prosecutors told us they have investigated the case and confirmed this attack, which they said was a war crime. But like so much here, the question why is the one without a humane, palatable answer.
Якщо б ми не вилізли з погріба їсти, він би нас не побачив і він, може б, і не тронув мене. Розказував вони, що він ходив по селу, ну, по селу, спрашував, кого можна. Ну, хто є такий, що легкого поведіння, як вони казали.
There are lives here that you can see Russia has changed forever, but also those whose trauma sits beneath the surface and lives on.
And Nick joins us now. It's just a horrifying story. I know you reached out to the Russian Ministry of Defense about this allegation. What did they say?
They have not responded, Anderson. In the past, I think they have suggested such claims are part of a pattern to try and paint Russian forces in a bad light, but frankly, the systematic nature of so many of the claims that we've been hearing, so similar, do suggest their veracity, as does, in fact, the conversations we've had with the Ukrainian prosecutors' offices here, who say they, through the victims' testimony and what they refer to as investigative work that they've done, have essentially confirmed her story, which they, as you heard in that report there, believe is a war crime, Anderson.
Nick Paton Walsh, just horrifying.